Mostly I tend to focus on snakes or other dangerous animals on land. But here, especially having the sea, on the Atlantic coast, we have these. This is a massive jellyfish. You can see all the tentacles are spread now in the sun. It's dead already. Whole gelatin around it. But the jellyfish I'm looking for are much smaller, more deadly, and come in huge masses to the beach. We'll see if we can find some.
Costa del Sol, Marbella. With a developing reputation worldwide, it is a place of scenic beauty and tradition. Marquis Ricardo Soriano introduced tourism in the 1940s, and it has been developing ever since. Inhabited since the Neolithic, it has stood under the Phoenicians, Romans, Arabs, Normans, Maronite sultans, and Catholic monarchs. But no matter if under dictatorship or democracy, this remained a stunning location, and is my home.
This is the Marbella that thousands of tourists come every year to see. On the beaches you can see many sorts of activities in the water, out of the water, bars. It's really amazing. However, the people forget that in the water there is a potential danger. There's a threat that lurks here. There have been news that jellyfish have finally come to the beach. So it's back out into the water now. You have to be really careful.
Jellyfish somewhere.
Okay, just watch out if it's coming your way.
Okay, well, we found a jellyfish and now we lost it again.
Oh, finally. Check this out. Catching up. This is a full-grown Pelagian Octiluca jellyfish. The morph stinger. There you go. Look at that. See, the tentacles are quite long, not as long as some other species, mind you. They grab it differently. See, this is the actual bell of the jellyfish on top. See, it's gorgeous. It's a truly beautiful jellyfish. Back in the water. He starts swimming. They swim around with the bell motion, the scooping water through. You see how they match in the water? It's like they glow with the purple. I want to find one of these with a hopefully longer tentacles to get it for research. We'll see, we'll have to find one.
But before I can find another jellyfish, I get called out to assist in a very different kind of situation.
Look at this, they brought
so
a lemur.
Cool. Look at that hand.
To the clinic. Yes, and they actually had a part of the broken tail. We just x-rayed him, had a broken bone. And that's a great shame because lemurs actually use their tail to signal. They hold the tail up and they signal between the group. Another amazing thing about lemurs is they're one of the only mammal species, or one of the few, that have matriarchs. So they're led by a female, by an alpha female. They're incredibly peaceful. All lemur species, about 105 of them, are endemic to Madagascar. And all are critically endangered by extinction because of deforestation, pet trade, hunting for food as well. You can tell it's a diurnal species of lemur by the eye color. So they have cute little things. And you can see also lemurs, like cats and dogs, they have a wet nose. You can see on the hand as well, they have special glands for marking the scent. And with these glands on the hand just here, they usually rub their tail as well, and then flush the tail around to spread the scent. So pretty.
This is so cute, isn't it?
I know.
They have no nails though.
No, but they have opposable thumbs as well, so they can grab branches and they can spring around. It's a ring-tailed lemur. It's gorgeous. You can see how long the tail is. You can imagine it raised. But this guy, yeah, sadly, he probably won't have such a maneuverability of a tail. Actually, of all mammal families, lemurs are the most critically endangered with extinction. The local efforts in Madagascar are really important, but also of all the zoos around the world. And here in Spain, the local zoos are doing a really good job of protecting lemur species. It's really special to see an animal like this. If you look at the hands really closely, it's almost like a human. And it can grab. Oh, we're gonna go back home now. So cool. Now lemurs, the word lemur actually comes from lemura, which in Roman mythology were ghosts or spirits. It was first applied to the slow loris or slender loris, and then later reapplied to the whole lemur family. Goodbye to our little friend. Okay. Yeah, here you can see this is the x-ray image itself. You can see where the bone was completely fractured here. See little pieces of bone actually coming out. Eventually, where the main bone will heal, these might come out and they will just become stuck in tissue. Let's hope the little guy heals.
Back on the beach, the jellyfish are always nearby. The pelagic creatures are brought in on the current, searching for food. I collect the sample I need from a deceased one on the shore.
Back at the clinic here, I got samples of jellyfish stingers now. I want to examine under a microscope, so I'll just start setting this up. Once we're set up, I'll show you how all this works. And hopefully we'll see the actual cells, the stinging nematocysts, fire under the microscope. That's what I'm hoping to do. Alright, that should be it. Okay. Okay, we'll have to improvise a little bit with a toothpick. Okay, so we have the sample in here, which I extracted from the jellyfish. Okay, there we go. Now, for the big reveal, I'm very lucky to have been allowed to use this thing. It's a proper professional microscope, a light microscope. So we place a slide on here, on the stage, and we have different lenses, different magnification, and it will look through there, through the eyepiece. Okay, so let's start this guy up, and then we look through here. What we see is the side of a tentacle on the top with extracted cells that have fired, but I'm interested to see how it happens. First, let's visualize a stinging cell, as what we see as little sacs are the nematocysts housing a harpoon soaked in venom with a thread for attachment coiled around it. In living cells, a nematocyst is housed within each cnidocyte cell with a special trigger on the membrane. Positioned along the tentacle, if anything touches the receptor, opening of calcium channels and osmotic pressure cause the harpoonal thread to be shot out, piercing any skin or flesh. In reality, this happens in nanoseconds.
but using special imaging techniques and fixing the sample in dense medium, it is possible to slow down the release of the harpoon. It's amazing to see the thread here slowly expanding. The liquid that was added is ethanol, as it makes all the nematocysts fire. The reason why you should never treat a jellyfish sting with alcohol. When the jellyfish is hunting, it'll spread its tentacles out in the water, so any fish swimming by, if it bumps into them, will be shot with a nematocyst, which will pierce the flesh, deliver the venom, and paralyze the fish. If you look closely here, you'll see another cell discharge. The jellyfish invasion happens here every summer, and as the world temperatures are increasing, so will their numbers. I'm sitting here at the summit with this awesome panorama. Throughout this series, I have explored all sorts of habitats to find and photograph the animals living there.
It's an absolutely gorgeous day.
These are Spain's most elusive creatures. Here we end our exploration, but there is a lot left to discover. Mm-hmm.